Hello everyone. In this video, I'll explain the use of any function and all function that are widely used in NumPy and where all are the situations wherein if you violate certain rules, you would get an error regarding an any function or an all function in NumPy. So let's start by importing NumPy as empty. The next thing that I do is I create an array called as ar_1 which contains values from 0 to 9. So this is how my ar_1 looks like. So if you're aware of how NumPy indexing works, you can basically have a condition of NumPy and you can filter out values based on that condition itself. For example, if I want to find out all the array elements which are greater than 5, I just have to write ar_1 > 5, which will return me an array of true false values. So this has returned me an array of index values which are either true or false based on the condition that I've supplied, that is my element greater than 5. So as you can clearly see, 0 is not greater than 5, so you have a false in the first element. 1 is not greater than 5, so again you have a false. At value 6, you observe that the value is true. So that simply signifies that the condition is satisfied. So once you have an array of trues and false, you can basically use that as a mask to index the array and to filter out values which are greater than 5. Wherein I have inputted the condition inside the square bracket and I have taken the output of the trues in form of an output, and that is what I observe here. So values 6, 7, 8 and 9 are true, rest of the values are false. I can do a similar exercise for all the values less than 8 by having a condition ar_1 < 8. If I have to now index and extract out the actual values, this is how I go about it. So as you can clearly see, values 0 to 7 are less than 8, which have been indexed out in my NumPy fashion. Now what if I have a custom condition wherein I want values greater than 5 and less than 8 to be indexed out? So if I go forward and if I type this command, which is ar_1 > 5, will give me all the indices wherein I have trues for values which are greater than 5, and I also want it to be ANDed against all the values which are less than 8. So now when I run the cell, I get an error. Let's go through the error and try to understand what the error says. It says that there is a value error. The truth value of an array with more than one element is ambiguous. Use a.any or a.all. I'll come to what a.any is and a.all is, but the problem here that has happened is, rather than using the normal AND operator which works on decimal numbers, if you look at these series values correctly, these are Boolean values or binary values which have values either true or false. In order to use a mathematical operator, your operator should be Boolean itself. So now I make use of something called as Boolean AND operator, which is the AND symbol, and I run the cell. And this is how I'm able to correctly index based on a condition inside my indexing scheme itself and come up with a solution. So if you see carefully, my condition was I want to extract out values which are greater than 5 and less than 8, which is what is satisfied by the output, which gives me a value of 6 and 7. So values 6 and 7 are greater than 5 yet less than 8. So this was my take on how you can do indexing properly by using binary operators such as AND, OR. Now coming to the use of any or all values. So let's create a simple array. So I create the second array called as ar_2. And I have just three elements in the array: 1, 4 and 5. I run the cell. When your NumPy array consists of decimal values, then when I say ar_2.any, it checks that if any of your decimal values are non-zero. If there is any single value that is non-zero, it will return a true. Okay. If this idea is clear, let's move on to the all function. I say ar_2.all. What all does is, in case of a decimal NumPy array, it checks if all your values are non-zero. So when I run the cell, I'll get a true value. If this idea is clear as to how it handles, say, decimal values, let's introduce a 0 in place of 4. Now I again modify my array, and now my array contains 1, 0, 5. So there is a 0 value in my NumPy array. Now if I run .any function, the value won't be changed because you have at least one value which is greater than 0. In our case, we have two such values, 1 and 5. So there is no concern of this giving me a false output. But on the other hand, since I've introduced a 0, now I'm expecting a false value to come in, since not all values are non-zero. Okay, so this was the case as to how any and all values handle decimal values. Now let's change the values of this array to true and false, which are Boolean values. So now when I run the cell, when the NumPy array has Boolean values, when you call the any function on that NumPy array, it checks if any of its value is a true value. So yes, I have a true value in my NumPy array, so it returns a true. In case of an all function, it checks if the NumPy array has all the values which are non-false. That is, all the values should be true to return a true from the all function. Now when I run the cell, I'll again get a false. So this was my take on how you can avoid an error like the truth value of an array with more than one element is ambiguous. Use a.any or a.all, how it can be avoided. Secondly, we also saw the nitty-gritties of any and all function when you have a NumPy array and how you can use it smartly while indexing as well. So I hope you found the video informative. If you do have any questions with what we've covered in this video, then feel free to ask in the comment section below and I'll do my best to answer those. If you enjoy these tutorials and would like to support them, then the easiest way is to simply like the video and give it a thumbs up. And also it's a huge help to share these videos with anyone whom you think would find them useful. Please consider clicking the subscribe button to be notified for future videos. And thank you so much for watching the video.